and that that decision could have been catastrophic, not only for that man, but for that little tiny child in the back seat.
Going 105 miles per hour down I-75, open bottles in the front seat. But it's what Florida Highway Patrol says they found in the back seat of that guy's car that's raising some more red flags.
Troopers say Grable Guzman and his 7-year-old granddaughter were in the back seat while driving drunk. NBC2's Zach Barrett walks us through this high-speed crime before he headed out to breaking news.
One Naples man completely disregarding the 70-mile-an-hour speed limit here on I-75 when troopers clocked him going more than 100 miles an hour down the interstate with precious cargo in the back seat.
Not a good way to start out the year of 2021.
42-year-old Grable Guzman starting his year behind bars after turning I-75 into a racetrack.
There was no reason for him to not obey those rules.
Troopers say Guzman was caught going 105 miles an hour with empty bottles of beer in the front seat.
Who knows where this man was driving to?
And a 7-year-old girl in the back.
That decision could have been catastrophic, not only for that man, but for that little tiny child in the back seat.
Guzman's license also expired for 6 months. Some mothers say close calls like these impact more than the lead foot behind the wheel.
It's not just the person that drank or the victim in the car. It's, you know, the relatives, the friends. It's just such a huge fallout.
Some saying the biggest impact coming from the innocent bystander, the 7-year-old in the back seat.
We really have to think about the mental health of that child and what that child was put through.
In a time of year when more drunk drivers are on the road, mothers like Sharon Kurgis are urging everyone to choose the safe option.
Call an Uber, a taxi, a friend.
Guzman is still in the Naples jail facing multiple charges, including first offense DUI enhanced because of that 7-year-old girl in the back seat. I'm reporting in Naples tonight. Zach Barrett, NBC2.